A miscarriage is the loss of a baby before the 20th week of pregnancy. The medical term for a miscarriage is spontaneous abortion. As many as 50% of all pregnancies end in miscarriage, most often before a woman misses a menstrual period or even knows they are pregnant. About 15 to 25% of recognized pregnancies will end in a miscarriage. More than 80% of miscarriages happen within the first 3 months of pregnancy. Miscarriages are less likely to happen after 20 weeks. When they do, doctors call them late miscarriages. Most miscarriages occur before the 12th week of pregnancy. Signs and symptoms of a miscarriage might include vaginal spotting or bleeding, pain or cramping in your abdomen or lower back, fluid or tissue passing from your vagina. It can be difficult to know exactly why a miscarriage happened, but it's rarely caused by something the pregnant person did. Normal activities like intercourse, exercise, working, and taking most medicines do not cause a miscarriage. Minor injuries, like falling, don't generally cause a miscarriage either. Some things that are known to cause miscarriages include: when the fertilized egg has an abnormal number of chromosomes, genes. This happens at random, so you can't prevent it or cause it to happen. Certain illnesses, like severe diabetes or thyroid disease. A very serious infection or a major injury may cause miscarriage. Late miscarriages may be caused by abnormalities in the uterus. A miscarriage sometimes happens when the mother has a weakness of the cervix. Doctors call this a cervical insufficiency. It means the cervix can't hold the pregnancy. This type of miscarriage usually happens in the second trimester. There are usually few symptoms before a miscarriage caused by cervical insufficiency. You may feel sudden pressure, your water might break, and tissue from the baby and placenta could leave your body without much pain. Doctors usually treat an insufficient cervix with a circling stitch in the next pregnancy, usually around 12 weeks. A woman has a higher risk of miscarriage if they are over age 35. Have certain diseases, such as diabetes or thyroid problems. Have had 3 or more miscarriages. There are several types of miscarriages. Number 1, threatened miscarriage. In this, there is vaginal bleeding and may have mild cramps, but the cervix stays closed. Half of the time, the bleeding stops, and pregnancy go on normally. The other half of threatened miscarriages become inevitable miscarriages, and end in pregnancy loss. Number 2, inevitable miscarriage. In this, there is increased bleeding, and the cervix opens. If this happens, there's no chance for the pregnancy to continue. Number 3, incomplete miscarriage. In this, some of the pregnancy tissue comes out of the uterus, and some stays inside. A person may need follow-up treatment to remove the remaining tissue. Number 4, complete miscarriage. All the pregnancy tissue comes out of the uterus. A person usually doesn't need any extra treatment. To diagnose miscarriage, your healthcare provider might do a variety of tests, including pelvic exam to check to see if your cervix has begun to dilate, ultrasound to check for a fetal heartbeat and determine if the embryo is developing as it should be, blood tests to check the level of the pregnancy hormone, human chorionic gonadotropin, in your blood and compare it to previous measurements. If the pattern of changes in your HCG level is abnormal, it could indicate a problem. Your healthcare provider might check to see if you're anemic. He may also check your blood type. Tissue tests if you have past tissue. Chromosomal tests if you've had 2 or more previous miscarriages. If, after a diagnosis of certain pregnancy loss, you'd prefer to speed the process, medication can cause your body to expel the pregnancy tissue and placenta. The medication can be taken by mouth or by insertion in the vagina. For about 70 to 90% of women, this treatment works within 24 hours. Another option is a minor surgical procedure called suction dilation and curettage, D&C. During this procedure, your healthcare provider dilates your cervix and removes tissue from the inside of your uterus. Complications are rare, but they might include damage to the connective tissue of your cervix or the uterine wall. Surgical treatment is needed if you have a miscarriage accompanied by heavy bleeding or signs of an infection. Hope you have liked this video. Don't forget to hit the like button. If you have any queries, leave a comment below. Also, subscribe to our channel for more medical-related videos.